Madam, the First Amendment is to implement the recommendation by the CPF advisory panel to allow members who turn 55 in 2013 or later to make a lump sum withdrawal of up to 20% from their retirement account when they reach the payout eligibility age, or PEA in short. With this change, members will have three options on their lump sum withdrawals. First, withdraw the lump sum starting from their PEA birthday. Second, defer withdrawing the lump sum beyond their payout start date for CPF Life or the retirement sum scheme by transferring this lump sum to the ordinary account. Third, convert the lump sum into money payout through CPF Life or the retirement sum scheme. The second amendment simplifies the activation of CPF payout for members on the retirement sum scheme. Today, members who join the CPF Life scheme will receive payout automatically when they reach age 70. However, members on the retirement sum scheme have to apply to start their payout. Some of them may not have done so despite receiving reminders from CPF Board around 2 months before their PEA. We are therefore amending the CPF Act to allow for automatic starting of payouts at age 70 for members of the retirement sum scheme. This approach is similar to that for CPF Life and will start in 2018. About 1 in 3 members are expected to benefit from the automatic starting of payouts under the retirement sum scheme. The third set of amendments updates the CPF Act to support the implementation of the basic healthcare sum, or BHS for short, which took effect on 1st of January 2016. The BHS was introduced by the Ministry of Health for CPF members to meet their basic subsidized healthcare needs in old age. The BHS is fixed for each cohort when they turn 65 years old. It's the maximum amount a member can set aside in his MediSave account. Any additional MediSave contributions above the BHS are transferred to the member's special or retirement accounts to increase his retirement income. In addition, members age 55 and above now no longer need to top up their MediSave account before withdrawing from their ordinary and special accounts. To fully effect these changes, we are amending the CPF Act to remove obsolete provisions relating to the MediSave minimum sum scheme, minimum sum, and fix a BHS for each cohort when they turn 65 years old. The fourth and last set of amendments provide greater clarity and efficiency in the administrations of some parts of the CPF system, and this include replacing minimum sum with retirement sum, clarifying administrative financial penalties framework, recovery of government grants and other payments made in error, and catering for members whose birthday fall on 29 February. I will provide just one example on simplifying the MediSave top-up process for family members. Today, members aged 55 and above who have already set aside their cohort full retirement sum have to withdraw the excess monies from their ordinary and special accounts in cash before they can use it to top up the MediSave account of certain family members aged 55 and above. So this amendment will enable members to make such top-up directly from their ordinary and special accounts to the MediSave accounts of these family members.